Chevy.
That really your dream? Where would you go?
Anywhere.
Anywhere, huh? Me too. In a heartbeat. Far, far away.
Damn it, Lorraine, I've been looking all over for you.
Well, now you found me.
Should have known. How to bill him for all the time he spends with you.
Shane and I are just friends. We're just talking about the future. What we're gonna do when the club is successful and we all make a little money.
Yeah. Come on. Let's go freshen up that glass of wine.
Since you asked so nice.
Yeah. Charlie was shot to death sometime around 8:30 tonight.
Doc.
It's Charlie.
Sheriff wants to see you.
Thank you.
Shirley, send Freddy in. Shirley, do you hear me? Damn it. Shirley! Go get Freddy.
Am I under arrest?
Hell, Shane. We know you didn't do it. The McLean girl killed Charlie. But we got enough to hold you on suspicion. You sunk a lot of dough in Charlie's joint, and so far we know you ain't taken much out. What did you and him fight about tonight?
He's been waiting for you for a long time.
You closing tonight?
Yes.
That's a shame.
You're late, my friend. Things are good with you? Things are very bad here. Very bad. They've raised our protection overhead more than 50%.
Theft break?
Tough luck for all of us.
You told me you wanted to take over the stump, and I went in on it. I dropped 50 grand.
We've got almost $10,000 in inventory.
So you could keep your brother and his mob contacts in vintage wine for a couple of months? You know damn well I'm not gonna put another dime in this place. Whatever I've done for her.
I know. Lorraine is going to get her divorce. Let's go in the back.
Knife. Down. Knees.
Brother shouldn't play with knives.
By God, Shane, one of us is gonna end up dead.
How are you, Sheriff?
This man was on an evidence job for Lorraine Ricas.
That's right.
Charlie's wife had Freddy on his tail. She got anything to do with this?
No. Why?
Didn't you and her used to be pretty good friends?
One shot. And I come up from where I'm stationed and go in. There's this guy, sprawled out, dead as a doornail. The gun was on the floor, and this broad McLean was in pajamas, yelling that she didn't do it.
Yeah, you told us all that before.
I know. Only now I'm telling him.
What's the girl say?
She's got a whole raft of stories. The best one being that she was asleep and didn't wake up till she heard the shots. She turned on the lights. There he was, laid out on the floor. Some kind of monster standing over him.
No fingerprints. Clean as a whistle. Except for the blood.
We're all done with you.
So long, Sheriff. Mr. Shane.
Thought you might help us clean up the loose ends.
I left the club about 8. I was back at my place a quarter after.
I guess that's all.
Mr. Shane! I was thinking there may be a few questions that the sheriff didn't think to ask.
Like what?
I'm a working man, Mr. Shane. Just trying to make a living. Know what I mean? God damn it, what's the idea of packing me off like that? Where are we? What are we doing out here?
Now talk.
I seen Miss Lorraine about half a block from the house where her husband was killed. I was just grabbing a bite to eat. The car pulls by and parks up a ways. Didn't notice much at first. Pretty sure it was her convertible.
Pretty sure.
Oh, hell. It was her car.
What did she do?
Well, maybe I was wrong. Because if it was her, she would have called because she'd want me to go in with her. So I sat in the car thinking about that, eating my burrito. In a few minutes, I heard the shots. Something else. I saw somebody driving away. Could have been anybody. Even Ms. Rigas.
You didn't tell the sheriff about this?
Gotta protect my clients. Kind of a jam, Mr. Shane. My wife is sick. Real sick. And I took an awful beating at the track the other day, trying to get enough jack for an operation. But you might appreciate how I protect my clients. How I keep my mouth shut.
Anybody else know what you saw? Did you tell anyone?
This it? Not that I ain't grateful, what with my sick wife and all, but I thought this would be worth a C-note at least. You ain't leaving me here!
Thank you.
Sure. Where are you? What's going on?
I knew you wouldn't just leave me out here.
Lorraine, you okay in there? Lorraine?
You've got to help me locate Del before he gets to Charlie. Del started drinking last night and he's been at it all day. He went out about 11. He said Del was over at his joint, roaring drunk and howling for Charlie's blood. He gets like that every time he gets tanked. Crazy jealous of Charlie and me.
Charlie Regis. God damn it.
Damn it, hon. Get off of him.
Go on me.
Charlie.
I told Jack to let him drink himself under the table. Or lock him up or something. A little while later, he called and said everything was all right. And that Del had passed out. And then around 3, the fella I had tailing Charlie, for evidence, called. Said he located the house where Charlie had been living with the McLean woman.
How long you been tailing Charlie?
3 days. Charlie stuffed him until today. I told him to stay at the house until he watched Charlie go in. I figured I'd go over there tonight, crash in with a load of witnesses. And then Charlie called up. He said everything was okay and he'd give me the divorce. Anytime, any place. I figured I'd go on as intended. Get whatever evidence and affidavits, whatever I needed. That way, if Charlie changed his mind. But we have to find Del.
Thought he was out cold at Kenny's.
I called over there to see how Del was. He was gone. He stole the gun from Jack's trunk and took off. I don't know if he'll do anything. But he goes nuts when he gets enough red eye under his belt.
You think Del would really make a run at Charlie?
He gets these crazy ideas of face to face and man to man. I know Del.
He's probably at home. Waiting for you.
No. I called.
Crazy about Del, aren't you?
He got me a ring.
Start.
If I knew where to start, I wouldn't be here. You've known Del for years. You know the screwy way his mind works. And the places. Where would Del go? Looking for Charlie. Other than 71.
Thank you.
find out. He got me a ring. He got me a ring. Where would Del go? Looking for Charlie. Other than 71.
Jack Kenny here.
Jack's out back sleep.
Wake him up.
What do you want to see him about?
Gonna tell him how to stay out of the can. Did you give Del?
Didn't give him nothing. Bastard stole it.
Charlie Regas was killed tonight.
What the hell are you talking about?
Oh. The 38 Smith & Wesson.
Oh. Oh, no.
Had the safety knocked off. Sound familiar?
Jesus, sweet Christ. Oh. No, hey, wait a minute. You sure?
Pretty dumb of Del to get so worked up about Lorraine that he killed Charlie.
Oh.
Lorraine's been washed up with Charlie for months.
Oh.
Del had to know that.
It wasn't Lorraine he was worrying about. It was that little bar hopper, Thelma or Selma or something. She worked for Charlie. Del's been two-timing Lorraine with her for a couple of weeks. She's the one he was all worked up about. Oh. And hey, he said he had something on her and Charlie.
Thank you.
There's a couple of stiffs at the old Pueblo Hotel. Room 20. Hurry up. The girl's not quite gone yet.
The McLean girl killed Charlie.
I saw somebody driving away. Could have been anybody. Even Miss Regas.
He stole the gun from Jack's truck and took off.
Up. They're waiting.
You bring him in?
He came in by himself.
They grabbed me when I opened the door. He was here and they were beating the hell out of him. I don't know when they picked him up.
After he talked to me. They've been in my tail all night.
One of you two killed Charlie. I find out who soon, or I kill you both.
You damn fool! When are you gonna get it through that nut of yours that Del killed Charlie? The gun they found was the one that Del swiped from Jack Kenny's this afternoon. Jack will verify that.
Shut up and sit down.
Holmes. Sweet Jesus. That is a fine piece of work. Bit heavy though. Heavy gun for heavy lad, huh?
I told you. I went there to warn Charlie that Del was after him. I heard shots before I got to the house. So I left. Shane, I didn't tell you because I was afraid you'd get ideas.
Where do I come in?
Well, you left here. Got to the motel about 8:50. Found that out from a friend at the front desk.
Where did you go after you left here?
You answer Mr. Regis when he asks you a question.
You should ask Nick where he went tonight.
Did you know that little waitress, Thelma, is Nick's gal? Did you know that Charlie's been playing around with her?
I saw him.
No, you're wrong.
At the house.
You're a goddamn liar.
No, not...
Good story.
Mr. Regis, you gotta believe, I would never...
Gino, go and get Whitey. What time did Nick leave last night?
He left right after Charlie went home.
No, Whitey. You got it wrong. All wrong.
Nick. Give it a rest.
He wanted to take in a picture show. He wanted me to take the door for a while. He got back around 9:00.
Nick had a hunch that Charlie was going to Thelma's, and went straight to her place. Didn't find Charlie, but he did find Del. Del's been making a big play for Thelma. He knew about her and Charlie, and he aimed to rub out the competition.
I'm gonna kill the son of a bitch.
Oh, baby, it's okay.
Thelma must have calmed Del down. Nick found them there and caved in Del's head. Nick beat the hell out of Thelma. Damn near killed her. Put the trophy that he cracked Del with in Thelma's hand. Poured some drain cleaner down her mouth. Made it look like she killed Del and then tried to off herself. He took the gun that Del got from Jack Kenny and headed over to Charlie's.
Finish it.
Nick knew that Charlie and I had a beef tonight, and it looked like me. He got there ahead of Charlie, and he waited in the dark, like shooting fish in a barrel. Nick came back here like nothing ever happened.
Mr. Regas.
You and the little lady can go.
What about him?
We'll fix him up. Give him some money.
Come again.
Where did you go after you left 71? Before you went back to the hotel?